Frontal sinus, sphenoidal sinus, antenasal opening, heart palate partition between the oral cavity and nasal cavity. In the nasal cavity, three concave, three meatuses. Posterior, the nasopharynx, we have tube, salpingopharyngeus, this is pharyngeal tonsil, hard palate, soft palate, between them is palatine aponeurosis. In the oral cavity, this muscle,
tongue,
this is genioglossus, this is geniohyoid. This is hyoid bone, mm-hmm. epiglottis, thyroid cartilage, cricoid cartilage. Right. Behind the oral cavity, all this is
oropharynx.
In the oropharynx, what you can see, from the palate to the tongue. Can you see this fold?
Yes.
This fold is palatoglossal fold. The same fold is posterior, green one, palatopharyngeus. Between them, there's a sinus, a gap. And that sinus is called as palatine sinus. In this sinus, there is palatine tonsil. Okay? Jill? It continues with the laryngopharynx. This is the larynx. This part, this area from inside, this is quadrate membrane. From the epiglottis to the retinoid, this is aryepiglottic fold. This upper part is called as vestibular fold. The lower part is called as
vocal fold.
And this is conus elasticus. Upper part here, the mucous membrane here, is supplied by internal laryngeal nerve. Below the vocal fold, it is supplied by recurrent laryngeal nerve. Right. Now, the nerve supply. Nerve supply, all the muscles of the tongue are supplied by hypoglossal nerve, except palatoglossus, which is supplied by pharyngeal plexus or vago accessory complex. All the muscles of the soft palate are supplied by pharyngeal plexus, except tensor palati, which is supplied by
mandibular
nerve. All the muscles of the pharynx are supplied by pharyngeal plexus, except salpingo pharyngeus, which is supplied by glossopharyngeal nerve. All the muscles of larynx are supplied by recurrent laryngeal nerve, except cricothyroid, which is supplied by external laryngeal nerve. Clear? Okay? So this is what we can ask in the